Today, I've got a really simple digital art design for you to follow along with in Adobe Photoshop. What is up, people? Welcome back to Satori Graphics, the home of graphic design content right here on YouTube. So I had a few subscribers that requested me to show you guys how to design this piece of digital art that I created to promote my custom typeface, Satori Sounds. For the background of this simple digital art design in Photoshop, I went over to a great website called Pixabay. Here you can download high resolution images to use for commercial use on all of your graphic design projects. I'm not sponsored by Pixabay, I just really like their website and use it often. So here is the image that I'm using today, and the link is in the description below if you want to use it for yourself. Double click the layer to unlock the layer in the layer window, and then duplicate the layer with Command or Control J. We do this so that if we make a mistake that goes beyond a point where we can step back with Command or Control Z, you can actually resort back to the original image. We're going to enhance the image first by adding a lighting effect. This might take some getting used to, but if you grab the effect in the middle, you can move it around your digital art design. If you place your cursor over a handle, you can either rotate the entire effect, or you can scale it up or down. If you then slide the circle icon around, the brightness is going to increase. So set this to whatever you feel looks best for your Photoshop design today. After it's been generated, you can press Command or Control Z to check the difference between having the lighting effect on or having it off. We're now going to duplicate the bottom layer with the Command or Control J again, and double click the layer to change the name to Dark. Click the eye icon on the top layer to hide it for a brief moment, and then change the brightness and contrast of the dark layer, essentially making it more dark. So go ahead and make the top layer visible again, and then take the eraser tool with a soft brush and a very low opacity. Now you can do the areas of the top layer around the corners where shadows exist, gradually making it more dramatic. So I think the stage is set and the background is ready for our simple digital art design in Photoshop. Press T to access the type tool, and then type out a letter. For my design, I use my custom typeface Satori Sans. I've made this video today as multiple people asked me to make a tutorial on how I design my artwork, promoting my custom font. There's a link in the description below if you do want to download it for yourself, and it's on sale right now. We need to rasterize the type layer so we can edit it and add certain effects. So when it's positioned and ready, lower the opacity a little so we can see behind it. Take the eraser tool, but this time use a hard brush and 100% opacity. You can now delete areas of the letter to create the illusion the clouds are in front of it. So when you're done, you can raise the opacity back to 100% on the letter, and then change the blend mode to overlay. Now you can go to the effects tab and add an outer glow. I'm using an almost white, very light blue for my outer glow effect, and the blend mode is set to normal. You can play around with the settings here until you're happy with your design. We're going to add yet more of a dramatic feel to the design, so create a new layer and then name it something like Highlights. You you can use the eyedropper tool to sample a color from the outer glow effect on your design. And then you want to take the brush tool with a soft brush and a low opacity. Now you simply just need to take your time and care to color in highlights over the clouds, mainly where the light would be reflected on top of them. This is going to really add to the overall effect in today's simple digital art design in Photoshop. So we're nearly finished and we have two more effects to add. Firstly, on the letter, we can add a color overlay. And I'm going to choose purple for my design. And then you can lower the opacity so it blends in a visual appealing manner. Again, play around with the settings for your design. Lastly, make a new layer and go ahead and name it Lens Flare. Choose a black foreground color, and then with the layer selected, hold down the Alt Option key and then press Backspace on your keyboard. This is going to fill the layer with black, and then you can go ahead and hide the letter layer and then change the blend mode of the black layer to screen. Now you can go ahead and add a lens flare, and again play around the settings and hit Command or Control Z to step back a space if it doesn't look ideal. You can also lower the opacity of this layer like I'm doing here. So remember to hit the like button if you're finding today's tutorial useful, and subscribe to Satori Graphics if you haven't done already. Finally, we're going to add some text to our design, and I'm using my custom font Satori Sans for this part of the tutorial. And essentially that is today's simple digital art design finished, requested by a few of my subscribers. So that was today's video on a simple digital art design using Adobe Photoshop. Let me know what you guys thought of today's video in the comment section below. Now, as recording this video, this is how many hours are left on my competition giveaway. I will announce the winners on Saturday, and there's going to be 5 in total. So thank you everyone to enter the giveaway, and there's going to be another giveaway at the 50,000 subscriber milestone. But anyway, until next time guys, design your future today. Peace.